हेलो एवरीबडी, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आर यू एंजॉयिंग? यस, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव सीन द सेलेक्शन ऑफ टर्बाइंस. दिस इज द लास्ट क्लास. आई एम श्योर दिस इज द लास्ट क्लास इन फिफ्थ बी यूनिट. ऑफ कोर्स फिफ्थ ए इज पेंडिंग फिफ्थ बी, बिकॉज फिफ्थ ए इज डिपेंडिंग अपॉन द टर्बाइंस ओनली. दैट्स वाई फिफ्थ ए वी विल टेक लिटल बिट लेटर. फिफ्थ बी इज कंप्लीट इफ आई डू वन लेक्चर ऑन ड्राफ्ट ट्यूब एंड कैविटेशन. ओके, ड्राफ्ट ट्यूब. The water after working on the turbine imparts its energy to the vanes and runner, thereby reducing its pressure less than that of the atmospheric pressure. The water after working on the turbine imparts its energy to the vanes and runner, thereby reducing its pressure less than that of the atmospheric pressure. As the water flows from higher pressure to the lower pressure, it cannot come out of the turbine, and hence a divergent tube is connected to the end of the turbine. That itself is nothing but known as draft tube. It is a divergent tube, one end of which is connected to the outlet of the turbine and other end is immersed well below the tile race, that is water level. The major function of the draft tube is to increase the pressure from the inlet to outlet of the draft tube as it flows through it and hence increase it more than more than the water after working on the turbine imparts its energy to the vanes and runner, thereby reducing its pressure less than that of the atmospheric pressure. As the water flows from higher pressure to the lower pressure, it cannot come out of the turbine, and hence a divergent tube is connected to the end of the turbine. Flows through it and hence increase it more than atmospheric pressure. The other function is to safely discharge the water that has worked on the turbine to tile race. You see here the figure, you can understand the draft tube. This is the draft tube. It has a conical shape or divergent shape. Right, this is the powerhouse, this is the generator, this is penstock through which water is flowing. This is the draft tube connected to the tile race, having varying cross section with elbow type or even straight type you can have. That will be in the form of conical shape but straight. That we will see in the next slide. Yes. Different draft tubes, straight type, elbow type are varying in cross section from this position to this position. It is having elbow and as well as straight. Is it clear? Now, cavitations. If the pressure of a liquid in course of its flow becomes equal to its vapor pressure at the existing temperature, then the liquid starts boiling and the pocket of vapors are formed which create vapor locks to the flow, and the flow is stopped. The phenomenon is known as cavitation. To avoid cavitation, the minimum pressure in the passage of a liquid flow should always be more than the vapor pressure of the liquid at the working temperature. That should be observed. In a reaction turbine, the point of minimum pressure is usually at the outlet end of the runner blades, that is at the inlet to the draft tube. See, the cavitation will form some bubbles surrounding liquid, increased static pressure. Here it is shown. Surrounding liquid increased the static pressure. Cavitation bubble imploding close to a fixed surface, generating a jet of the surrounding liquid. Due to cavitation, part of the turbines will be get worn out. Ultimately, it fails to work efficiently. So as to make it effective and efficient, work is to be got done by the turbines. The material which is used to manufacture should be very good steel, stainless steel is to be used. We sometimes call it as Salem steel. If I remember, Salem steel is very good steel material which will not be subjected to the effect of cavitation. We cannot avoid to 100% cavitation. There will be some cavitation, will always take place. However, we can minimize the effect of cavitation. Now, we'll see the causes of cavitation. What are the various causes of cavitation? What are the different causes? We will see. The liquid enters hydraulic turbines at high pressure. This pressure is a combination of static and dynamic components. Dynamic pressure of the liquid is by the virtue of flow velocity, and the other component, static pressure, is the actual fluid pressure which the fluid applies and which is acted upon it. Static pressure governs the process of vapor bubble formation or boiling. Thus, cavitation can occur near the fast moving blades of the turbine, where local dynamic head increases due to the action of blades, which causes static pressure to fall. Cavitation also occurs at the exit of the turbine, as the liquid has lost. How to avoid cavitation? To avoid cavitation while operating hydraulic turbines, parameters should be set such that at any point of flow, static pressure may not fall below the vapor pressure of the liquid. You have to see that the different parameters of hydraulic turbine should be selected such that at any point of flow, static pressure may not fall below the vapor pressure of the liquid. Then cavitation can be avoided. These parameters to control cavitation are pressure head, flow rate, and exit pressure of the liquid. The control parameters for cavitation, free operation of hydraulic turbines, can be obtained by conducting tests on model on the turbine under consideration. The parameters beyond which cavitation starts and just half a minute. Cavitation starts and turbine efficiency falls significantly should be avoided when operation of hydraulic turbines. The parameters beyond which cavitation starts and turbine efficiency falls significantly should be avoided while operation of hydraulic turbines. Other methods to avoid cavitations. Runner or turbine may be kept under water. Cavitation free runner may be designed by selecting materials that can resist better the cavitation effect, means anti-cavitation material or resistant material such as stainless steel with other enamels coated on the material should be used for manufacturing of various parts of turbines. By polishing the surfaces, it is also possible to reduce or minimize the effect of cavitation. By selecting a runner of proper specific speed also for a given load will reduces the effect of cavitation. Thank you very much. This completes 5th B. Okay. 5th B is completed in all respects. Numerical problems also sufficiently we have solved. And everything is solved so that 5th B is complete. We are left with 5th A part. In one or two classes, it will be over. And then 4th and 6th units are left. Okay? Thank you. Have a good day. Please start looking through the literatures. Whatever the material we have sent to you, at least utilize daily. At least 15 to 20 minutes, I hope. There should not be any problem to any students. After all, you have joined for the engineering course. You should see that at least you should make use of the facility available or the facility which is made available to you in the form of PDF notes, PPT notes, even good handwritten notes also we have uploaded. Number of numerical problems with solutions in the handwritten notes you can find. Thereby also it is better. Please do have that. Continue in the next class.